moving coil galvanometer, the construction. It consists of a rectangular coil with n number of turns of copper. This rectangular coil is suspended with the help of a phosphor bronze wire. Why we take phosphor bronze wire? Because one, its strength is more. Next, its torsional constant is very less. If you want to improve furtherly the sensitivity of moving coil galvanometer, we can replace this phosphor bronze wire by quartz wire. This rectangular coil is placed between two concave poles. These two magnetic concave poles will provide magnetic field. Why we have to select the concave poles? Because concave poles will generate radial magnetic field. Why radial field is required? Because the angle between the area vector of the coil and the magnetic field is always maintained at 90 degrees. So that in the formula of torque, BINA sine theta, that sine theta factor will become 1. That is, when radial field is generated, the rectangular coil will experience maximum torque. The other end of the coil is connected to a hair spring. The hair spring is working like a connector. At the same time, it provides a restoring torque for the coil. A metal cylinder is placed inside the coil to concentrate the magnetic field lines. The principle of moving coil galvanometer on which it works is, when any current carrying coil is placed in a magnetic field, it experiences torque. That means you have to note down the value of the deflection here. That deflection can be noted with the help of this concave mirror. To note down the deflections, we have to make the lamp and scale arrangement. When the current is passed through the coil, it will be deflected. The light falls on concave mirror and the image of the concave mirror will also be deflected along with the concave mirror. In the lamp and scale arrangement, we can find out the deflection of the coil. Now, let us derive the expression for current in the moving coil galvanometer. We also see the original galvanometer and we will compare the parts that are described here. You can observe the shape of the magnetic poles here, concave poles. And here you can observe the rectangular coil. So this is the rectangular coil. In the middle of the rectangular coil, there is a metal cylinder. Now here you can see the spring. So this spring is nothing but hair spring that we have described in the construction. This hair spring will provide restoring torque. When galvanometer is attached in any circuit between two points, the current will pass through the rectangular coil. So the rectangular coil is rotated and then
Because of that, the spring will also be tightened, and then at the equilibrium position, the two torques, the torque provided by the current, that is BINA sine theta, is also equal to the torque provided by the hairspring. Now, when the coil is rotated, a needle is connected here, and that needle will be placed on this surface. You can see the original galvanometer. So these are all the parts of this type of galvanometer.